In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at the rib feature, which is basically just a simple way of adding structural support to a part. It's a shortcut for something that you could do with the extrude feature, but it just makes this particular task a little easier. So let's say I had some kind of a box here. I'm only showing three walls, but I wanted to add some extra structural support to that in the form of some ribs or braces. I'm going to start by getting myself a new plane here. And I'm just going to demonstrate this by drawing a simple diagonal line here on this new plane that I put out. Actually, it's not necessary for this to be coincident here. You can even do that. Okay, so we've got this diagonal line, this diagonal sketch that's in the middle of these two faces here. With this sketch selected, I'm going to go up and choose the rib feature. And by default, it's going to say that its extrusion direction is parallel to sketch. And just to show you what's going to happen here, it creates a rib like this. Let's go back and take a look at these settings. So basically, it has gone 10 millimeters, a total of 10 millimeter width here, using my sketch line as the center. And it has gone in a direction that is parallel to the sketch itself. And it's extruding out into the nearby body. If I wanted to, I could flip the side that it goes to. This would probably cause an error, actually. But if for some reason it chooses to put the extrusion out in the wrong direction, you can just use this flip material side here. Alternately, if I had chosen normal to sketch, it would do the extrusion out in normal to the plane that the sketch is on. So if I were to do this, then the rib would go out this way. So those are two different options that you have when doing the rib. We could do a slightly more complex profile for the rib. Let's suppress this. And again, using this plane, I'll do a new sketch. And this time, let me do something like this. Oops. And maybe we have a curve here. It's going to be kind of large. And maybe we have something like that. So notice that I don't necessarily have to have these lines terminate where the rib itself is going to terminate. Sometimes this will cause an error, but usually it's managed to deal with it. So let's see what happens here if I try a rib. That time, these sketches are going too far outside the body. So let's adjust this sketch. And I'm going to bring these in a little more. Like this. So we'll try this. Oh, I see what's going on. This is an example where it's trying to extrude out the wrong direction, so I need to hit flip material side here, and then it'll work. And similarly, if I had chosen normal to sketch, I would get a rib that looks like this. So, you know, again, rib is just a shortcut to things that you could do with an extrusion. It's just a little easier to, it makes it a little easier to do this specific kind of operation.